floating bits of genetic material, parasites or ancestors of cells, what are viruses, and why do they even exist? That is a question no one can answer, but is the only purpose of viruses just to make us sick, or do they actually play an important role in the survival of the planet? To explain that, we must first know what viruses are, and what is it that makes them so different? A virus particle, known as the virion, consists only of genetic material enclosed in a protective protein shell. Very simple indeed, but here's what sets them apart from other organisms. In short, viruses don't possess the cell machinery which is necessary for reproduction. They lack nuclei, organelles, or ribosomes that all the other cells own. So they have to invade, inject the genetic material, utilize other cells as an engine, and as a result, they multiply, spread, and ultimately cause disease. That is exactly why many scientists don't consider them to be living organisms at all, as even though they carry genetic material and can mutate and adapt, viruses cannot survive without a host cell. Therefore, to counter this, they evolve to infect all forms of life, from bacteria to plants, animals, and even humans. Viruses are found almost everywhere. They're some of the most abundant and diverse beings on the entire planet. There are a million of viral types, but only a small fraction actually poses a threat to humans. To illustrate this best, in just 1 milliliter of seawater, you can find 10 million viruses. Some of them are crucial for our environment, especially in the marine ecosystem, where they play a significant role in nutrient cycles and oxygen production. It was recently discovered that half of all oxygen we breathe in is produced because of viruses infecting microorganisms in the oceans. So instead of being considered only as our enemies, viruses appear to have an important role in the generation of oxygen, the most essential molecule for our life. It is still unclear why and how did viruses actually emerge, but there are three main hypotheses. First, the progressive or escape hypothesis. It states that viruses arose from genetic elements that escaped from the genes of larger organisms. These jumping genes gain the ability to independently move in between cells, transferring genetic information from one organism to another. When the pieces of genetic material enter a host cell, they can be transcribed and translated. As a result, copies of the viral genes are produced, and now they can exit the cell and begin the process again. The next is the regressive or reduction hypothesis, which suggests that viruses are remnants of free living cellular organisms that became parasites over time. These viruses parasited larger cells such as bacteria, and as they became more and more dependent on the host cell, they lost the genes that were essential for the survival outside of a cell, as they didn't really need them. Consequently, they became unable to replicate independently, which made them completely reliant on other cells. And the last is the virus-first hypothesis. Previously mentioned theories assume that cells existed before viruses, but this one proposes that viruses existed first, or they co-evolved with other cells. Most scientists today agree that RNA, a form of genetic material, appeared first, and then over time organized structures such as cells formed, so it is assumed that viruses may have emerged before or at the same time as the cells first appeared on Earth billions of years ago. So, maybe viruses are ancestors of cellular life as we know it today. Recent study revealed the surprising presence of a giant virus called a Tupin virus, which has a more complete set of cell machinery. This discovery alone has shaken up the virus evolution debate, but it may help in the illumination of their origins. How exactly viruses evolved remains unclear. However, further studies will reveal the right answer. Till then, there are only theories. Thank you for watching. Check out how we stop a pandemic by clicking on the screen, and also check out our Instagram page where we post daily facts. See you next time.